Hey guys, it's Mike from the Geek Pub, and today we're going to talk about something super important to your arcade build that almost no one talks about. Joystick restrictor gates. This video is sponsored by PCBWay, so before we get started, let's thank them for supporting us. If you're not familiar with PCBWay, their goal is to be the most professional PCB manufacturer for prototyping and low-volume production work in the world. New customers get a $5 bonus on their first order. Thank you, PCBWay! Okay, before we get into it, let's take a minute to understand the basics of joysticks. Trust me, this is important. Let's start with talking about their movement behaviors. Joysticks have four possible states they can be in at any given time. These states can vary wildly between different designs and different manufacturers. Joysticks default to a state we call neutral. This is the position in which it rests when not being held and the position it returns to when you release it. Ideally, in a properly manufactured joystick, this would be perpendicular and plumb to the top plate of the joystick. The second state is one we call the dead zone. The dead zone is the amount we can move the joystick in any direction without actually engaging any of the micro switches. Having some dead zone is actually a good thing. All joysticks need some amount to compensate for most players' tendencies to not hold the joystick dead center. However, too much dead zone in cheap joysticks can cause gameplay to be very sloppy. The next state is referred to as engaged. This means the micro switch has been engaged and the signal is being sent to the electronics that movement has occurred. However, in most joysticks, there is enough play in the micro switch that the stick has not reached the end of its travel. This brings us to what we call throw. This is where the joystick has completed its travel and can move no further. The micro switch should be bottomed out at this position. I hope this is all making sense, but just in case it's not, let's take another look from the bottom of the joystick. First we have neutral, then we have the dead zone, followed by engaged, and then finally we have full throw. Okay, so now that we understand states and behaviors of the joystick, let's talk just ever so slightly about the directions. So most joysticks, including the ones that we ship, are considered eight-way joysticks. That means that it moves into the up position, down position, left position, right position, and all of the diagonal positions. Now, there are some rare joysticks that actually have individual micro switches for the corners, for the diagonals, but most joysticks will simply activate two micro switches. Like if you push the left up diagonal, it simply activates the left micro switch and the up micro switch at the same time. So have you ever played a game like Pac-Man and you're running from the ghosts and you push in a diagonal position and nothing happens? Pac-Man doesn't do anything. Well, that's because Pac-Man was designed to work with a four-way joystick. And so when you push the joystick into the diagonal position, it activates two micro switches. The game software simply ignores it. And that's why you get eaten by the ghost. And so when you're playing Pac-Man, you're constantly having to make sure that you push up, down, left, right, and never go into any of the diagonals. Well, there's a solution for that. And that's why restrictor gates are so important. If you turn the joystick upside down, you'll notice a piece of plastic on the bottom that the joystick protrudes through. This piece of plastic is called a restrictor gate, and it controls the positions that the joystick can move into. Some restrictor gates are wide open, like this round one, and let the joystick move in any direction, while others, like this two-way plate, completely eliminate all but two directions. You can turn restrictor gates 90 degrees to change how they operate. These two-way restrictor gates are permanently molded. However, many restrictor gates use inserts that allow you to adjust them. Most joysticks ship with a square gate installed, and indeed, if you look at the bottom of our joysticks, you will see an insert-style square gate. Now, you can turn this square gate 45 degrees. Now, many people think that you are eliminating eight-way when you turn the square gate 45 degrees, but that's actually not what's happening. The square gate simply, based on its position, simply makes the joystick prefer the diagonals or prefer the standard up, down, left, right positions. You can see how if we have the square gate in the default position, the stick will prefer the diagonal positions. But if we turn the gate 45 degrees, it will prefer the standard up, down, left, right positions, perfect for playing Pac-Man. Some games like Space Invaders only have two directions. If you've built a Space Invaders cabinet, you'll probably want to use a two-way gate set in the left-right orientation. In this illustration, you can see how different shapes of restrictor gates will change how the movement of the joystick is distributed or limited. And it's right about this point that you're asking yourself, well, which one do I use? And I hate to say this and give a cop-out answer, but the truth of the matter is the one that fits your personal preference. If you play a lot of Pac-Man games and, you know, things like Rally X and, you know, Donkey Kong and things that were really designed for a four-way joystick, I'd probably recommend that you use a square gate turned 45 degrees, or you use a plus gate, which completely eliminates the diagonals. Now, if you're playing a lot of games that are like fighting games, then I probably would, you know, the ones that have like all the different moves, I probably would go with an octagonal gate because it has a detent for all eight positions. And so here's the good news. The good news is you can try a gate, and if you don't like it, it's really easy. I mean, it takes like 30 seconds to snap this off and snap a new one on, if that long. So you can try different gates, figure out which one fits your playing style or the games that you like the most, and then go with that. Another thing to be aware of is that not all joysticks actually even support restrictor gates. So make sure that when you purchase your joysticks, that you get ones, if you want to use restrictor gates, that is, make sure that you get a joystick that supports them. Well, that about wraps it up for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.